I'm gonna have to do something here. Give me a second, guys. Wrong HDMI cord. Let's see. Because it's not even plugged in. Hold on a minute, guys. I need to figure this out. It'll take me a minute. I have so many HDMI cords. It's not even funny. All right. So today, we had a new DLC pack that just came out. And we are going to do the DLC pack today. So alright, so it looks like Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows are looking like a best overall team here. And we're gonna turn off the entrances. I mean, turn on the entrances.
The most extravagant, flamboyant, eccentric, and gorgeous team in WWE history. The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 350, Kid Wilson, Pretty Deadly. Here's a team who are completely in sync with each other, the epitome of teamwork. And they're also in sync when it comes to annoying their opponents as well. Yes, boy. Stop saying that. Come on, Byron. Give me one. Yes, boy. No, I'm not saying it, Corey. Do it. Do it. Can be deceiving. Oh, come on, Cole. Don't judge a book by its gorgeous cover. You try, Cole. Yes, boy. Come on, Cole. Please. Don't say it, Michael. Don't say it. These two are all about beating people up and winning gold. And they have won gold all over the world. And their opponents at a combined weight of 505 pounds. Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC! You know you are in for an all-out fight facing the OC. Two men with a high in-ring IQ, high intensity, and high goals to achieve. You can see the look of intensity on their faces already. The fun and games are over. I am not envious of their opponents at all. They're in store for an old-fashioned butt-whooping, guys. And this tag team match is sure to be filled with exciting action. These teams want the tonight, and they'll fight hard to get it. Superstars look like they're all business, not a weak link among them. Prince saw that was coming. Tag. Landing an uppercut. He manages to escape the tag. Look at this, just unloading. Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off. See you.
I'm back, guys. Alright, guys, so we'll be doing the tag team match and a one-on-one match between the female side. And we're going to do a fatal four-way to see who is the better male superstar in this DLC pack. So how many DLCs do we got? I know Harley Race to the NXT pack is coming out next month. And a leg drop one and a kick out. Well, Carl Anderson broke it up. Oh, wait a minute. Luke Gallows with a big boot. Oh, a back dropped. One. What a gutsy performance. Playing tag for his partner. All right, so let's see here. DLC. Who's gonna be in the next DLC pack? Continuing to work on the arm. Carefully measured. So, for the next pack, we got Harley Race, Ivy, Tony D'Angelo, Trick Williams, and Wendy Chu. Interesting, interesting. And then the next pack, which is refill with the Wyatt pack. Bear Davenport, Bray Wyatt, Joe Gacy, Valhalla, and Seuss will be on July 19th DLC. I don't like how it's like every month. I feel like they should do it like every 3 weeks, but that's just me. Like they used to. Like they should do it like every 30 weeks or so. And this year's DLC pack is kinda, it's kinda short. Yeah, this DLC pack, or year, is kind of a short one. You remember when Nash Carter was supposed to be in the game? Tag in.
But the entertainment on that one was off the charts.
Here are your winners, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC!
And they get the win, thanks in large part to Carl Anderson.
Really putting the sports in sports entertainment. This is a duo that really practiced their teamwork.
Alright, I'm back, guys. Well, I just come to realize I can't really do a one-on-one match. So, we're gonna have to wait until the next DLC comes out. Hold on a minute, guys. Let me make this a elimination match. Alright. So, in this match, we are going to see who's the best DLC person from the male side. So, what are we going to do? DLC. All right, here we go.
Well, here comes a man who calls himself one of the two most handsome creatures on the earth. It's actually three, because you neglected to include me.
I think you're actually delusional.
The following contest is a fatal four-way Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring, representing Pretty Deadly from Gray's England, weighing in at 172 pounds, Elton Prince.
A living, breathing, blonde bombshell. Well-versed tag team experience has to prove himself outside of Pretty Deadly.
I came with this motherfucker.
Well, it's time to see if he can actually focus on what matters here and not his hair.
Well, the reality is, Saxton, he's been in the game for over a decade. I'd say it's time to remind people.
Here comes the toughest man in the building.
And the man who proudly answered the call of AJ Styles.
Okay.
Representing the OC by way of Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 213 pounds, Carl Anderson.
One of the most feared gaijin in Japanese wrestling history, Carl Anderson has earned the nickname the Machine Gun.
Get this, Carl Anderson has held tag titles in Japan for a total of 1,165 days. That is the most for a non-Japanese superstar.
Well, he's a tag team specialist. He's proven he can get things done on his own.
I can't with this. This guy.
And representing Pretty Deadly from London, England, weighing in at 185 pounds, Kit Wilson.
Well, it doesn't get more self-absorbed, except for maybe his partner in crime.
Well, lucky for him, he's used to jealousy from the masses and peers, and this guy does not let it faze him.
Continue his legendary career.
Big man with big intentions.
And representing the OC by way of Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 292 pounds, Luke Gallows.
Wait, did I hear that right? Did he said from Tokyo, Japan? What's up, Rockstar? How you doing? Alrighty, here we go. Damn. Here's a cover. Oh damn. Is that Prince over there, my guy? Yo, Prince, calm down. Oh, tag team partners colliding in this fatal four-way match. DLC showcase. We already did the tag team match and the OC picked up the W. He got a steel chair. Oh, tag team partners colliding here. Every man for himself. This is kind of weird. Oh, to the table. And I think Prince has been eliminated. We are down to the final three. Oh, you got the steel chair. sending Luke Gallows through the barricade. Oh, the kendo stick. This is a brutal three-way match. Falls count anywhere. Elimination match. Oh, a steer chair. The rocket kick! One, two. I think that's his finisher now. The rocket kick. Oh no, that's his signature move. I thought that was his finisher. Guess not. And the kendo stick. In the uppercut to the back. So after this match, guys, we will be live with RCW. Oh, a kick out. Carl Anderson, Luke Gallows, and Kent. Oh, Keith. Oh, I have no idea. Targeting the leg. Luke Gallows with the baseball bat. One, two. Carl Anderson has been eliminated. It all comes down to Wilson and Gallows. He will be going to be the best DLC person in this. Oh, he was trying to set up the ladder there. Oh! He hit the ladder so hard, the ladder disappeared. Oh, the Kendo stick! I think that could do it. One, two, Gallows kicks out. DDT. Gallows just waiting. Oh, Wilson reverse. Here's a cover. Wilson kicks out. He's getting a steel chair. Oh, Gallows. And I think that might have caused Wilson. Oh. To the steer. He is knockout cold. Again. And the third time. He's getting back up. And that has to do it. Gallows is the best DLC person. What a victory from Gallows. Alright guys, we are about to go live with RCW right now. Alright. Trago versus right. What? Oh, I was about to have a heart attack, bro. We'll see you now. All right.
For the single leg DDT. Stepping through. Legs all locked up here. Just punishing their opponents.
We talk a lot about Trish Stratus as someone with an endless amount of strengths, but what about her weaknesses, Corey?
Well, Cole, that's because we all know Trish did a lot of work to turn her weaknesses into strengths. But all the training in the world.
I'm back, guys.
ringside.
Okay. To the back again.
Perfect. trip outside.
Now for Britt Baker. Submission. That do it. Stratus couldn't get the job done. Elbow to the chest. In a DDT. Here's a cover. 1, 2. She pinned the All-Star Champion. We do gotta take that into consideration though. She did pin the All-Star Champion. Alright, so the next match, we got ourselves a three-way junior heavyweight title match. All right, so we got Guy Phoenix. This is Call of Duty. Versus Okro. The winner of this will go into Hello, how you doing? What's going on? What is going on? Alrighty, so we got a three-way matchup. I thought I may win a 90 overall game. Come on now. Okay, so I'm gonna make this an 80. Awesome. We're gonna do a three-way. Say his name and he appears. I believe in Joe Hendry. God, Phoenix, Finn Balor. Hey, man. Yo, Pierce. Alright, so it's gonna be Finn Balor, Balor Boy, taking on Joe Hendry versus Zach Barnett. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
here comes one of my favorites.
Alright guys, I'm gonna be right back real quick. Oh, I'm playing.
Baseball. So close. He's looking to do whatever it takes to survive.
Oh, man, you can see he is feeling it now.
Throws the opposition back into the ring. Thank you. Standing moonsault. He's back into the ring. And he'll leave the ring for this next stretch.
Sweat on
He's taking a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Kick to the gut.
Here is your winner, the hero, Joe Henry.
And what a victory, surviving and ultimately thriving in a match like this.
Yeah, you cannot discount just how much endurance went into coming out on top in a match like this.
I'm back, guys. Sorry. I had to deal with something. Man, where is it? Alright guys, so coming up next we got Selena Matthews versus Rhea Ripley.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from Baltimore, Maryland, Selena Matthews.
Such a tenacious talent, always digging down deep to get the win.
Well, that's what's endeared them so much to the WWE universe.
You know what happens when you dig down deep all the time? You bury yourself and you fall to the bottom, and that's exactly what's going to happen tonight.
Does this woman have the answer for Ripley's trademark toughness, do you believe?
Cole, I don't know if there's anybody in WWE or beyond who can match raw power with the Eradicator, Rhea Ripley.
Presenting the Judgment Day from Adelaide, Australia, one half of the Women's World Tag Team Champions, Rhea Ripley.
Physically imposing and a talented athlete.
This is a woman who knows how to put her strength to devastating use. Rhea Ripley is capable of anything inside the ring.
You've got to respect that.
Yeah.
And the Eradicator about to pass her judgment. The wrist. Just absolutely punishing their opponent here. Relentlessly.
Ripley in a surprising bit of danger.
Ripley's experiencing some brutality.
This is gonna hurt.
Rhea Ripley in a state of distress.
Ripley has to stop struggling.
Oh, forget about pandering to the WWE Universe. That should keep her head in the game. Oh, side cutting.
Two.
Shoulder.
kill with a smile and wound with her eyes.
Said he put in the ring now.
Looking to force her opponent to quit.
Trying to get her to tap out.
Trout and nowhere to go.
Except for maybe the emergency room or the locker room. This is going to be bad. Shit, my God. This could be an opportunity.
carefully placed stop.
And she's gone after her opponent's core a few times now.
Is
let's get another look at some of the high points of that one.
Here is your winner, Selena Matthews.
Well, what are they celebrating, but I think they're hiding an injury, guys.
I can't tell from here how bad that injury is. Let's just hope it doesn't shelve them for too long.
A big win coming at a bigger cost.